have 10 minutes. Make this quick.
Yes. We were calling to inform you that a new business inquiry is available. And we're interested to see if you were interested in the offer while it's still available.
Well, that depends on the place and what would I have to do. Five star guy.
Yes, yes. Oh, and you would also need to be in Boston in time for our ceremony.
Okay. I'll be there.
Excellent. Pleasure doing business with you, sir. Good day.
Good grief.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back from commercial break. And ladies and gentlemen, I have just been informed that Charles Fisher will be having an open challenge right here and now. Did you hear anything about this, James?
To be honest, I haven't been told a single thing. I'm just as surprised as you are, but just listen to the reaction that these fans are giving five-star Charles Fisher. Normally, we're usually greeted to Charles Fisher coming out to an uproar of applause and adulation, but instead, we're having some mixed feelings here in Boston, Massachusetts.
Well, you have to think about it from the One World fans' perspective, James. Charles is, in the most literal sense, a day one member of this roster. So many of the fan base, could feel a bit sad, kind of like stabbed in the heart, because Charles has gone on to this mythic status almost, traveling the independent scene, making his name known, while ignoring the very company that started the very five-star Fisher name.
Charles Fisher overrated. And Charles Fisher grabbing a microphone. Let's see what Charles has to say.
As you guys know, I issued an open challenge tonight for anybody across the land of professional wrestling. And quite frankly, I don't give a flying fuck who it is, because I know what the result is going to be, regardless of my opponent. Five-star motherfucking Fisher with his hand raised and declared winner of the match. So I don't give a damn if it's Gary Frank Simpson, Vogan, hell, I wouldn't even fear if Namo himself came out. So whoever One World found, why don't you just hurry your sorry ass up and come out already.
Wow. Absolute scumbag.
You're gonna say that again. And wait a minute.
What the hell?
Whoa.
Lights turned off. Somebody must be here, but who is it?
James, do you recognize this music at all?
I think I do, but it can't be. There's no way he's here. James, there's no chance.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's gone completely dim here in the arena. These fans are wondering who's going to come out and answer the challenge.
Oh my god! Malakai is in One World Pro Wrestling!
I'm just... wow.
This is a sight to behold. This is a moment in time that we will never forget. Malakai making his One World debut in battle in Boston.
Ladies and gentlemen, you gotta know that Charles Fisher is just... he has to be in shock to know that his opponent is none other than the Ghost himself. This is gonna be a good one.
Hey, referee, tell this bum it's ass to the ring.
Charles Fisher does not want to wait any longer as Malakai is staring a hole into Charles Fisher. Just listen to 1 minute. We were hearing an uproar of boos and chants of overrated, but now we're just hearing chants of holy shit echo throughout the Boston, Massachusetts arena. As ladies and gentlemen, Charles Fisher is going to be in for the fight of his life. And now, if there's one thing I know for certain about Charles Fisher, he loves to try to put on a five-star performance in any match, whether it be major or minor. But you got to know that this is going to be an instant classic to say the least. Contest is underway as both men sizing each other up.
This is gonna be something. Genuinely, this is a moment in time that I don't know if people will ever forget. There's something just about this aura, this presence that Malakai brings makes anything that has happened on this show from here on out seem, and this is no offense to anybody who had to show up before Malakai, but whoever did, boy, I bet they're looking a little foolish now that the ghost is here.
Oh, both men. Wait a minute. Tripping up. Has the shoulder pinned to the mat. Ooh, wait a minute. Malakai turning it around. One. Charles Fisher now. One. Malakai now. One. Both men going back and forth with the covers here. Just absolutely evenly matched here in the early going to this matchup. First two count from Charles Fisher. First two count from Malakai.
The fans.
My God.
The absolute constant uproar.
Going for German. For a German suplex there. Charles Fisher. Wait a minute.
Malakai.
Something with the wrist. Wait a minute. Look at Malakai.
Oh,
look at the athleticism. Okay, now in control. Irish whip to the ropes. Looking down. Wait a minute. Look at Charles Fisher. Charles Fisher. Now, wait a minute. Malakai caught him. Wait a minute. Oh, stomping on the foot of the ghost. And wait a minute. Jean-Claude Van Damme. No. Try for the Jean-Claude Van Damme kick in the early goings. Wait a minute. Malakai with Malakai. Charles Fisher moving out the way. Charles Fisher. Irish whip. Wait a minute. Malakai turning it around now. Malakai ducking down. Leapfrog over the five stars. Wait a minute. Leapfrog again. Okay, going Charles Fisher, I'll tell him to bring it. Huge Japanese arm drag from the ghost.
Absolutely incredible. Malakai seemingly laying on all of the offense on his five-star Fisher. I bet Fisher is regretting even so uttering those words. Five-star Fisher, you want to put on a five-star performance. If there's not a man who can do it, that's Malakai.
But you're shut. Oh. Y'all need to shut the fuck up. You know what? Fuck this shit.
Okay.
I'm out. Screw this match.
Oh, come on.
Are you kidding me?
Charles Fisher.
You people? I'm going
home. Charles Fisher leaving. He's done with. Wait a minute. Look at Malakai. Look at Malakai. Look at Malakai. Oh!
You ain't getting out of this ass so easy.
Malakai throwing Charles Fisher back into the ring as this fight continues.
Ooh. Oh!
Try for something there, and Malakai just slapping the taste out of his mouth.
Oh my God!
Huge knee strike right there from Malakai, and now this time, another one for added measure. He's got him really in the corner.
He's falling for it.
Charging!
Oh!
Vintage Malakai right there with the series of moves. Only getting a 10 count for his efforts.
Any taste that Mr. Fisher had in his taste buds.
Hey guys, do you think Charles is giving a five-star performance? No? I don't think so either. We're not done yet.
As I was saying, anything that Charles could be tasting from here on out is going to be nothing but soup. With strikes like that, look at this though, Charles.
Wait a minute, look at this. Oh, wait a minute.
Wow!
Using the ropes to give him assistance for that Hurricane Rana. One. Two, and an immediate kick out from Malakai. And now Charles Fisher is going to work on the back of Malakai. And now just doing push-ups on it.
Peep the muscle game, bitch.
so arrogant as Charles Fisher has once again into the cover. One, we're only getting a one count. We're wasting so much time there with theatrics. Now, if there's one thing I know for certain about Charles Fisher, James, is that Charles Fisher is actually supposed to be the number one contender for the Madness Championship, but ever since Blood in the Water and ever since Ace losing said title to Isaiah Smoothman, it's even questioned as to what exactly is Charles Fisher's position when it comes to the Madness Championship. But right now, we got to focus on the action here in One World Battle in Boston as Malachi now with a side headlock of his own.
You'd have to think, though, that maybe that number one contendership being taken away from him, maybe that's what's fueling his rage a little bit tonight. Maybe Malachi could be getting the short end of the stick in terms of Charles Fisher's performance, because maybe he's not looking for a five-star. Maybe he's just looking to prove a point.
Out the ropes. Wait, try for the sick kick there. Charles Fisher moving out the way at the last second. As Charles Fisher now stalking like a vulture stalking for some dead meat in the sand. Turns him around. That's a snapmare takedown. Fisher off the ropes. Ooh, try for a knee right there. But Malachi moving out the way. Dead eyes in the back of his head as Malachi now throwing Charles Fisher to the outside. Wait a minute.
Here he goes.
Fans, look at Malachi. Look at Malachi. Look at Malachi. Look at Malachi. Oh,
wait a minute. Wait. Fisher. Look at Fisher.
Charles Fisher back in the ring, turns in! Look at this!
Oh my God! Tornado DDT! Like only somebody like
that's right, baby. I can do this shit all damn day.
And once again, just talking so much smack as Charles Fisher, ever so arrogant, is five-star Charles Fisher and Lena.
Well, what do we have?
What is he?
Is
are
he
you
grabbing?
Kidding?
Six!
What?
This is
unbelievable.
A joke, right? Somebody Seven. Is playing a joke on us. Because
it's Charles Fisher who's playing the joke on us. He's got Malachi's mask on here. And, oh, God.
God.
Two. No. Oh. There's one thing I know about Charles Fisher is he, like I said before, he loves to try to pull on a five-star performance, whether the match is major or minor. But look at Charles Fisher now. Look at this. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. He's getting back into the cup and leg tilt, shoulders to the mat. And Malachi's still alive in this one. But yeah, Charles Fisher tends to try to always put on his best performance each and every single match. I mean, granted, that's a good mentality to have, but sometimes if you let certain arrogance go to your head, it, well, makes you be an asshole. Excuse my language. But, ooh.
I mean, I definitely feel like there's no fear for language because Charles is definitely an asshole. He's portraying it right here in front of our very eyes. He has the mask of Malachi, and he's wearing it while beating the shit out of him. If that isn't an asshole, I don't know what the definition of the word is.
Nice. Malachi got the leg. Malachi's got the foot, actually. And, oh, just tripping him up. Face first into the canvas. And wait a minute. Malachi,
no.
Oh.
Oh.
Back and forth, repeating round, asking across the chest. Wait a minute. Able to get the hands up. Gone by the leg. Oh, huge shin breaker right there. Oh, huge enziguri counter right there. And it's got him.
Malachi.
No. Oh, tried for the Requiem. He tried for the Requiem. And Charles had it static.
Got him. If he hit that, I think it would have been ball game. Nothing Charles Fisher would have been able to do to kick out of that.
This way, man. Charles Fisher now. Oh! Just dropping him face first onto the turnbuckle. Wait a minute, Charles Fisher now charging on it.
Bitch!
Oh, come on. What a dick. Jesus Christ.
Ever the showman is Charles Fisher. Proving that he has the gift of the jab and the gift of the gab.
This man ain't shit. He's pathetic.
I genuinely can't believe this man.
Absolutely despicable. Oh my God. That's throwing him back to the outside, and this fight's continuing on the outside. Ladies and gentlemen, I highly advise you to step away a few feet if you wouldn't want to get caught in the action here. As he's got Malachi reeling it. Oh, sending his face first into the. And now just look. The gift of gab and the gift of jab being put on display. Oh my God.
Hey, AOC,
Y'all looking for some real fighters?
Sam!
Beat the footwork,
wow.
Yeah, boy.
And back in the ring.
No.
Count you both out.
You are not going to finish that count. I'm not done with this bitch just yet.
Well, I don't care. I have a job to do. Get him back in the ring.
Oh, what the hell? What the hell is wrong with you?
He just took down our referee!
Jean-Claude Van Damme kicked to the official! You have got to be kidding me and not just throwing the official on the outside! Like a piece of trash, what the hell? Absolutely despicable actions on the part of Charles. Whoa, what the hell are you doing?
He's destroying everything in his path! If it's the referee, Malakai, or even our goddamn announcer's table! This is why he's the scum of the earth! Screw this man! Boo this man louder!
Charles Fisher just took apart our announcer table, and now he's got
him on top of the... Now he's got us! Now he's got Malakai on top of our table!
What is he doing now? Come on, really?
Give me that camera.
I can't give you the camera. What are you doing?
I don't give a shit. Give me that camera right now, bitch.
Are you serious? Dude, what are you doing? What the hell?
Are you serious?
And to all those in the live chat, I better be seeing some fucking news when I get home. Because this is y'all's hero. Hey, Malakai, when you watch this later, remember this one, dickface.
What a piece of shit, man.
Hey, Charles.
The fuck?
Over here.
No.
Here's your five-star crazy! Oh my god! Riptide! Through the table! That's exactly what you get! That is exactly what you get! My god! You alright, James? Holy!
I have no words! I'm absolutely flabbergasted of what the carnage that we have seen here tonight!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we got a new official out here right now. It's both men laid out in front of us after that thunderous rip time through the announcer table. He took his eye off the ball for a split second, and Malakai, at the last second, was able to hit that rip time and send five-star Charles Fisher crashing through the table.
Six.
Somebody sent something to check on the other official,
Seven.
But Malakai right now dragging dead weight back to the
Eight.
Ring. You gotta know that both of these men are spent.
Nine.
And surprisingly, both men
How
make,
much more punishment?
Surprisingly, sorry to cut you off, James, but both men making it back into the ring before the count of 10. Just... Jesus Christ! This was honestly unexpected from both of these men. Just giving us one hell of a matchup here in Boston, Massachusetts for Battle in Boston.
They are feuding like they have been doing so for years. This is incredible. This is a moment to remember. This is what One World Pro Wrestling is all about.
Charles Fisher wanted this match. He wanted a challenge, and he's certainly getting it here tonight as both men staring each other down as these fans are chanting fight in unison. And Bo had a hand out!
Jean-Claude Van Damme to no, right ass kick attempt. Oh, tried to sweep the leg. Jean-Claude Van Damme, no, caught the leg again. Wait a minute. Ooh, time for a wheel kick. No. Wait a minute. Charles Fisher turning around. I'll get back to his feet. Kicks the leg.
Jean-Claude Van Damme kick.
That's got to do it.
This could be it for Malakai.
Two.
The ghost survives.
So many attempts at the Jean-Claude Van Damme kick throughout this match. And finally, Charles Fisher was able to hit and connect with that said super kick. And now I think he's trying to go for the end.
Get up!
Helix jump, perhaps? A bit unorthodox. to pull Malakai to his feet to hit it.
No.
You are done.
Charles Fisher now sizing up the girl. Charles Fisher, Helix jump. Oh my God! Requiem! Catching him in mid-flight of the Helix jump. And now Malakai stalking, sizing him up in the corner as he's looking to send him for the end, charging. There's that knee strike. He's got him into the fireman carry position. Revelations cutter!
Count it, Rip!
Malakai has a victory! Dismantle Charles Fisher! Holy shit! My goodness, what a match! Charles Fisher laying out the challenge! And the ghost was the one to answer the call. And silence. 5 stars. And now Charles Fisher is seeing stars as Malakai is standing tall here tonight. My goodness, what a match. But ladies and gentlemen, coming up next is our main event for the One World Heavyweight Championship between Everett Costanelli and Keith Matthews. My Lord, what a match.
This all could have been avoided. All you had to do was give me the respect I deserved. But once again, you chose to be the prideful one and not to acknowledge the better man. You miserable fuck! Being lucky and being so generous. This right here is nothing compared to what I'm going to do to you at In Over Your Head. But don't worry, I'll be seeing you soon. Real soon.
Matthews charging. Ooh, call with a clothesline from Everett Costanelli.